Kenya police versus Haiti gangs leader. You know very well that right now the Kenya police are in Haiti fighting with the Haiti gang leaders. Try to bring peace among the Haitians and the Haiti gang leaders. You know very well that Kenya police were in the forefront helping the Haitians to get their freedom back from the gangs. They tried so hard and hope there will be peace in Haiti and the people in Haiti are going to stay in peace and unity. Hello guys, welcome to our YouTube channel. Thank you so much for the support. Thank you so much for the love. You guys are great. You guys are so great. Ondunana, today's story is Kenya police versus Haiti gangs. You know very well that the Kenya police have done so much to the Haitians. The first thing that after the Kenya police went to Haiti, they were able to bring back a big hospital which was captured 6 months ago by the gangs. The gangs were able to capture the hospital and were putting so many people in hostages. They were putting people in that place. But due to the battles between the gangs and the Kenya police, know very well that it's not only the Kenya police. It's a lot of police over there from different countries trying to help Haiti get their freedom back after a lot of captivity from the gang leader. You know very well that the biggest gang in Haiti is called the G9, which is headed by a person called Barbecue, is the leader of the G9, aka the real name of that guy, the gang leader, is called that Jimmy Cherizier. That is the lead gang leader of the G9, which is mostly feared by people in Ogopua, feared so much by the Haitians. They fear the guy. But 6 months ago, he was able to capture a port where so many things that were being exported, imported in Haiti were going against his favor. He was getting a lot of favor after capturing the port and high taxation, taking high taxation from Haitian so that he can continue with his criminal activities in Haiti. They were able to reclaim the port from the gangs, from the big gangs. That is what the Kenya police did. The second thing that the Kenya police did, they were able to recapture, to reclaim the hospital that were being used by the gangs to put the hostages. Hapo ndo penye walikuwa wanaweza kuwekwa. But due to the energy and due to the force of the Kenya police, they were able to do that. Congratulations to the Kenya police. They are doing a nice job in Haiti, helping the Haitians. Hope that everything is going to be okay. That is something that they did last week. This week, the main aim of the Kenya police and the police that are outside there in Haiti, you know very well that this is their last week in Haiti. Hope that after they got out from Haiti, there is going to be peace, love, and unity among the Haitians. Their last plan for this week is how they are going to capture the lead gang leader in Haiti, who is Barbecue, to capture Barbecue and prehend him in prison for what he has done to so many people in Haiti. So many people don't love Barbecue. In that guy has been helping a lot of people in Haiti, has been helping, because this guy thinks that the West want to take away Haiti from him. After this guy was the leader, he was the leader of the commander-in-chief of the armed force in Haiti. He was the leader. After the death of their president, who's Jovenel Moïse, this guy took over the government. And there was no president, Jaikwana president in Haiti, after the assassination of Jovenel Moïse, who was killed by a rival gang of the Mojito, he was called Mojito. The rival gang of G9 was called Mojito. He was able to kill the president of the Haitians. Hope that peace is going to be there. Hope that this week the Kenya police are going to do their best and make the Haitians to be able to stay in peace and unity. Hope that everything is going to be okay. Congratulations to the Kenya police. Congratulations. So many people say that if the Kenya police goes there, there are so many people that are going to lose their life. There are so many people that are going to be reluctant. There are so many police officers that are not going to help Haitians get back to their ways. But we are seeing the fruits. We are seeing so many fruits. This is now the second biggest thing that they have done in Haiti so far after going there. The first thing, they recapture back the port from the gangs. The second thing, they recapture back the hospital from that gang. This is the final week of the Kenya police in Haiti. You know very well that last week, but one, the Kenya police, they were able to send another 400 police officer to Haiti. They only remain with 400 to send back, to send to Haiti. Hope that there's going to be peace in Haiti. And hope that the leader, the gang leader of the Haiti is going to surrender and going to say that, my friend, I've decided to surrender and I would like Haiti to be great again. And the Kenya police and all the police that are outside there fighting for Haiti, kudos. You guys are great, risking your life so that other countries can be well, risking your life so that everything in Haiti can be getting back to normal. The Kenya police went to Congo. They did an amazing work in that Atangeza could restore peace back, but they did amazing things. Kenya police, you have done an amazing job, and we as Kenyans, we are very, very happy and proud of you guys. If barbecue, if you love Haiti and you are proud to be an Haitian, kindly just surrender. There is no bad thing, there is no nini. If you surrender, doesn't mean that you are weak. You surrender so that there could be peace restored in Haiti. Just surrender and give yourself to the authority and enable and tell your people to stop war in that Haiti. If you love your land, don't make your land, your country to shed blood because of you. The Kenya police haven't even shedded blood. It has been a peaceful, even if it was a gun battle between the gang and the police that were trying to restore those things. Those things haven't been restored easy. They did their best. It was gun battle between the gang and the police who are there in Haiti. Imekuwa vita ingine moja pale hatari. Now, their main aim and their main plan is how they are going to capture the gang leader with barbecue and be able to spend all his entire life in prison for what he has done to the Haitians. Hope that the Kenya police are going to do their best, and hope that the police outside there are going to do their best, association with the Asian police, to restore peace back in Haitians. Haitians are one of us. You guys, we are black like you, and we are going to do our best to make you get back to form. I know there's so many people, there's so many Haitians that are living afraid. Everything is going to be okay. The Prime Minister declined a dialogue between the gang leader with barbecue and the Prime Minister of Haiti. Declined a dialogue. We don't know the reason why the Prime Minister decided to decline the dialogue between the criminal. But the main reason is for you to be able to do a dialogue with person who have caused this thing in your country. Mwenye ameleta shida in your country, it's very hard for someone to have a dialogue with someone like that. Ni ngumu sana. In that you are the head of state, you are the big person in state. So, it's like dialoguing with a terrorist. And there's no negotiation with a terrorist. It's for you to go to bars or something bad might happen to you. Barbecue, is time for you to give yourself to the authority and say that you want this thing to get over. In case you do that, everything is going to be okay. Peace is going to be restored in Haiti and everything is going to be okay. That is what has happened. My briefing today was the Kenya police versus the Haitian gang leader. And the Kenya police have won a big, big, big time by doing their best and making the country to be back in their foot once again. I've been your host, Jeff Otieno. Until next time, game over.